Hi friends, Radhika Ravi Kumar here. So in this tutorial, we'll see what are the difference between procedure and functions. So there's something else I want to say regarding the procedure and function. That is, even as you have created the function and procedure, we know that it is a reusable code and it will be stored in the database. So even you can drop those things, like just mentioning drop. Then if you want to drop a function, then just say function. Okay. If you are dropping a procedure, then just say drop procedure followed by the name. Okay, just say drop function, and let me drop the function f2. Okay, you can see the function is dropped. In the same way, if you want to drop the procedure, then just say drop procedure, then give the name of the procedure something, and the same thing will be dropped. Okay, so now let us go and see the difference between the procedure and functions. Okay, so first difference between the procedure and function is, the first one is the procedure may or may not return a value, but we know very well that function should return a value. This is the major difference between the procedure and functions. Then the second one, the store procedure cannot be called from the SQL statement. We'll see how what it exactly means. Okay, but the procedure cannot be called from this SQL statement, whereas this function can be called from the SQL statement. That is, for example, let me describe this F1 for you, function. So you can see it returns a varchar. It's taking an employee number. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to say select F1, and I'm going to pass the value to the function using an SQL statement. You can see this select is nothing but it's the start of the SQL statement. So I'm going to say 7788 here. I'm passing the employee number and say from dual table. Okay. And you can see the result here. So you can pass the value, the function value, through an SQL statement. That is, it can be called from the SQL statement. That is what this difference means. Whereas the procedure can't be called from the SQL statement. Okay. Then the next difference is where this SQL procedure can't be used in an expression directly. It can't be used in expression directly, okay, whereas this function can be used in expression directly. That is what it exactly means is, when we are calling a procedure, like for example, I'm just calling a function called p1, and I'm passing the value like 7788, and I'm passing B cell. Then here, when I say VT something like equal to B cell plus 9000, then end it. You can't do these kind of expressions. You cannot add or something. You can't do all these kind of expressions using when you're calling these procedures. Whereas when you do this the same thing in the function, this is valid here, this can be done. Okay, sorry, in functions this is valid. You can use your expressions here in the function directly in the program. So the next difference is, where the procedure may or may not have a return keyword. You know very well this return keyword is not there in procedure. That means you can have it, no issues, may or may not have, whereas function should always have the return keyword. Okay, and also so this is the difference between the procedure and function. So this may or may not return a value, this should return a value, and this can't be called in the SQL statement as I showed here. this can be called from the SQL statement. Then can't be used in expression directly, as we have seen here. Then this can be used in the expression directly, and this may or may not have a return keyword. This should have a return keyword. So this is the difference, and hope you people have understood the procedure and as well as function. So if there are any queries, then please let me know. Just mail me at plsql.informatica@gmail.com, and I'll surely get back to you as soon as possible. And thank you very much for watching.